Keeping the law of Arvut is what should eventually bring us to the revelation of the state of faith above reason. Meaning, the feeling entering into keeping the spiritual state that will exist in us and we will exist in it. The law of Arvut opens up for us horizons, new horizons, in which we feel how much, on the one hand, we must reach connection between us, and on the other hand, how impossible it is to do it with our own strength. And here, we come to a state where the law of Arvut has to exist, not only between us, but between us and the Creator. That He will be the guarantor. So we will be able to be connected between us all the way to keeping the law of Arvut. Since if the Creator will not build, as it's written, if the Creator did not will not build a home, a house, all the work would be in vain. Since we would not be able to build this house, this soul connection. Hence, the law of Arvut always has to be connected between us and with the Creator together. So we wish to be connected between us so that the Creator will keep this connection. He will be the guarantor for that connection. He will use this connection in order to be to reveal Himself in us. So His revelation between us will be only so He would delight in the fact that we're making room for Him between us, called Shechina. And then He is called Shochen, the dweller. And He fills the space between us, the upper light that enters the vessels and fills them, where those vessels are the will to receive, that is equipped with the light of Chasadim. Since then, the revelation of the Creator in us will be entirely in order to bestow in equivalence of form with Him. And this way we come to a state called faith above reason, where we feel that by ourselves we're not able to be connected, no matter how much we try, and we should try, and we should do everything we can towards a connection relative to returning to the corrected vessel of Adam HaRishon. Everything that's within your power to do, you should do. But together with that, we discover that it is utterly impossible, and to discover that it is impossible, and we are, instead of despair, and I'm better off dead, I can't go this way or that way, neither here nor there, I have nothing else I can do with myself, with my life, to continue like all of humanity, what's the benefit from that? To reach spirituality, I don't know what it is, why is it? I feel I don't have the strength. I've lost even the desire for it. So what do we do? And here comes to us a form that is called work above reason, where we wish to be connected between us, to be connected with the Creator, on the condition. In fact, we have no conditions. We constantly try to think only of that, how to be adhered between us and with the Creator. Imagine to ourselves such an internal state inside of us. How can we do it? And in this way, to hold ourselves. I go to bed, I wake up, I do something, I work, I go, I sit, I study. It doesn't matter what I do. Rather, I do one thing and one thing only. I constantly think that I want to be in a state where I'm connected with everyone and from them with the Creator. And from that point, I exist. From that point, I do everything. Whatever I have to do in life, I do everything in this way, meaning I build inside of me the feeling, the knowledge, the state where I have a permanent connection with the friends and with the Creator. I'm in it, I'm adhered to it, glued to it, I'm holding on to it, I never let go of it. And from that point of connection, this is called Israel Oraita Kuchebrichu Chadhu. A man and the ten and the Creator are together. From that, I get all my life. Life, death, it doesn't matter what. I'm constantly only in that.